Hello, Sagittarius, and welcome to Soul Sundays. Sagittarius, it's a quick three-card spread, three cards from the tarot, one romance oracle card, one for your health, and because we have a particular special week this week with a full moon eclipse in the sign of Capricorn happening on Sunday, the 5th of July, I'm going to draw for you an extra oracle card from the Chakra Mindset deck. So let's get started. Universe and angels, messages and guides, my higher self, I call upon you now to give me a clear and accurate reading for the sign of Sagittarius. Please show me what they need to hear, not what they want to hear for their week ahead. Spirit, can I please have three cards, one for mind, body and soul? All right, so eclipse energy is here, whether we like it or not. This is the last of the Cancer Capricorn eclipses that have been happening for the last 2.5 years. So for some of you, it can really feel like you've been juggling quite a fair bit, okay? I mean, haven't we all? It's been crazy times with everything that's happening in the world at the moment. But for you in particular, you're about to have a big change. Something's about to change and be eclipsed out of your life. I feel like it has to do with work. And if you haven't seen the video that I did last week, go back and have a look, because I talk about where this eclipse falls in for you, Sagittarius. And for you, it's in your house of gains, what you do, what you build, what you create in a material sense, your tangible rewards, right? So I'm seeing changes here for you when it comes to career. For some of you, you could be ending a career, a job, resigning, walking away. This eclipse could be changing out that cycle for you. And for others of you, it's all around your persona of who you are in the world. Hopefully you can see that okay. So you start off with Scorpio energy. And I don't want you to be too worried about how bleak this card looks, okay? But it's the Tower. So the reason why I tell you not to be too worried about it is because it's come out with the Six of Wands. So as a tarot reader, my job is to use the cards as a forum, a means of ways of connecting with you. But I channel spirit and I get the messages that come through that tell me specific things that are relevant to you and your sign and for the Sagittarius collective. For you, it's all about a change in your foundation. Often people see the Tower card and they freak out. They're like, oh, what does that mean? What's happening? It's all about taking some time out for yourself. You have the Four of Swords here, which represents the need to rest, reconsider, just take a breather. Some of you could be in the spotlight. You could be in a position of fame. And the Spirit's saying, what do you mean by that? So what I mean by that is like you could have quite a strong following on social media. You could be in a position of high authority within your work or within your community. And for some of you, you could actually just be famous for whatever it is that you do, whatever your purpose is within the world. This week, this eclipse is bringing in a shift and a change in that area for you, okay? So you're being asked not to resist this change. They're saying, don't resist it, try and go with the flow as much as you can. I know that's easier said than done. I'm on the other side of the camera, but if you can actually just try and go with the energy, it will work out in your favor. Try and not challenge it. You may feel very differently on the inside, but if you can, just take a step back and go, okay, this is all happening for me, to me, for a reason. Something good's going to come out of it. If you are taking a redundancy, if you're walking away from a job, if you are choosing to end a cycle within whatever it is that you do and create in the world. Maybe you're no longer going to be working for yourself and you're taking some time out before you go to work for someone else again. Just remember, it's really important that you do take some time out just to catch your feelings, to catch your breath, to catch your thoughts, okay? This is a card that shows me rest. Rest is needed this week. And I mentioned feelings because in your health card, it's come up with listen to your intuitive feelings. So it's really important that you try and block the noise out, okay? Particularly if it is to do with what's happening around your workplace and it feels just like the earth's crumbling underneath you. Try and just hone in on how you feel and what's important to you. You are going to come out on top, Sagittarius, okay? Whatever this change is, however, it relates to you personally. And I'd love to hear, because I'm getting so many different avenues and they're showing me so many different visualizations. So write in the comments below. I do read all of them. But whatever it is for you personally, however it's manifesting in the 3D, the message is very clear, is just to go with the flow and take some time to rest. You've drawn the card of nurture for your relationships. This represents the Empress in traditional tarot. What's interesting about this in this position is it's all about nurturing yourself, self-love, right? I know that's such an overused term and it can seem so wanky sometimes, but it's really important. One of the biggest lessons that I'm still continuing to learn in all of my intimate relationships, be they sexual, be they just friendship, be they, you know, with my family, is how important it is to nurture myself first, okay? Because I can't be relying on those other people or those other connections to fulfill what's missing for me. And I'm going to read it to you from the book. It says, cherish, nourish, blossom, abundance, nature, creativity. The nurture card reminds you to tend to the garden. Right? Relationships must be nourished in order to thrive. Count the abundant blessings of the relationships you have. Find ways to let other people know that you care for them and appreciate them. Good relationships can be taken to new levels of happiness, and faltering relationships can be revived with loving care and attention. Equally, be sure to tend to your relationship with yourself. What was I saying? Nurture your soul by giving yourself the grace to be who you really are and love yourself for it. Take a few moments every day to connect with the divine. Meditate, go for a walk in nature, or simply have an attitude of gratitude. Nurture your mind by engaging in activities that stimulate you and engage. Use your creativity in some way every day. For example, everyone has the ability to be creative. Whether you paint, whether you write, cook, sew, sing, whatever it is that you do that contributes to your happiness, this is the invitation to do that. Make sure you take care of your body by maintaining good health or by making it healthy. Relax with a bubble bath, enjoy a good cup of tea, or take a long walk. Connecting with nature will soothe all aspects of yourself. Remember that nurturing yourself also raises your vibration and sends a signal of love into the universe. If you desire it, that signal will be a beacon that will bring a new and loving relationship to you. So exactly perfect on point for what I was saying before about going with the flow, nurturing yourself so that you can come out more victorious, Sagittarius. And interestingly enough, your chakra mindset card for this week was all about your root chakra. So again, this aligns perfectly with the eclipse being in your house of your material gains, your material wealth, what it is that you do in the world. And it's asking you to focus on your root chakra and be grounded, okay? So for some of you, it could feel like with the loss of this job or the change and whatever it is that you do, you may not have a job, you may be a contractor, I'm not sure, it's gonna be different for everyone. It's asking you to really connect yourself back to the basics, right? Now, the energy of this card really speaks about being connected to Mother Earth. That's what it is. Essentially, there's a tree growing out from the palms and there's rain coming through and it's talking about the cycle of life. Grounding is a spiritual term for actually getting your feet onto the ground, actually feeling the power of the universe, right? And it can seem a little bit silly when I explain it like that, but it's really important. It will do wonders for you. If you live near water and can walk on the beach barefoot, allow the waves to come up and kind of touch your feet and then take away any negative emotions. That's great energy clearing. If you are able to get out into a forest or trees, that would be great. In the mountains, in the country, anything where there's a lot of natural air and space, trees, anything where you can actually just connect to nature, okay? And the meaning of this card says, lack of grounding in your life may have led you to feel lightheaded and disconnected. This lack of connection can have an impact on your physical body and well-being. It's time to spread your roots and allow yourself to feel grounded. And there's a mantra that goes with it if you meditate, and it says, I let the energy of Mother Earth flow through me. I am grounded and strong. So it's really essential for you to spend time in nature this week and understand that no matter what's going on, look at the polarities of this card, right? In one hand, it can feel like everything's being pulled from underneath you. On the other hand, it's just a reminder that you're exactly where you need to be right now with whatever is going down around you, okay? Keep your thoughts positive. Keep your energy high by being in nature. Remember to nurture yourself. All the self-love bullshit that you can imagine. You know this, right? Eating well, bubble baths. You know, if you want that glass of wine, have that glass of wine. Whatever it is that makes you feel nurtured and full, it's important, really important for you to do this week. And look, if you are going through a change of job or you are feeling unsettled, just know it's temporary energy, okay? This is not going to be for you with you for long. This eclipse will come through on the Sunday on the 5th when this reading is recorded for you. Then by the end of the week, you will see a shift. So I'm excited to see what comes up for you next week. All right, Sagittarius, that was your reading. I hope you found it helpful. I wish you much love and light this week. If you did like the video, please hit the thumbs up and I'll be back with you next week. Take care.